So the concept of aliasing is known to us, the concept of Nyquist rate is known to us, and with this concept of Nyquist rate, let me again tell you people that this Nyquist criteria tells us that to recover that analog signal from its samples correctly, our sampling frequency should be at least twice greater than the maximum frequency of the analog signal. From this particular criteria, the sampling theorem developed is, and sampling theorem is developed, and that sampling theorem tells me that a continuous time signal with having frequency, highest frequency as f max, if it is sampled with a sampling frequency fs in such a way that sampling frequency is twice greater than the f max, then it can be correct recovered from its sampled version, and that is nothing but my sampling theorem. Let us try to find out what happens in case we don't follow the Nyquist criteria of sampling there. That means if we don't follow that sampling frequency should be twice greater than the maximum frequency of that signal, of the analog signal, then what happens? Let us try to understand. So for that purpose, I want all of you to dictate that problem. Let us say that, please note down that problem, wherever, whatever you have in your hand, you can note it down. I'll solve the entire thing on board. An analog sinusoidal signal, which is a combination of x1 of t and x2 of t, is sampled at a sampling rate. The sampling rate given, the sampling frequency given here is 40 hertz, is sampled at a rate 40 hertz. Find out the corresponding discrete time signal. If I have a particular x of t, which is a combination of x1 of t and x2 of t, shortly I'll be giving you the values of x1 of t and x2 of t. If this particular signal is sampled at a frequency of 40 hertz, you are required to obtain the discrete time signal, and we are again required to comment on the result that we have obtained through this operation. In this case, let me say that x1 of t is cos 2 pi 10 t, and x2 of t is cos 2 pi 50 t. Okay, and this combination is required to be x of t is nothing but x1 of t plus x2 of t, and we are required to sample both these signals, the subparts of that particular signal, at a sampling frequency of 40 hertz. Let us try to obtain the result, and then let us try to comment on the result. So let us only focus upon x1 of t. Let me say that this x1 of t is sampled at t is equals to nts. Then what we are going to come across is x1 of n. Always do have a practice of denoting the discrete time signals or the digital signals in the square brackets. So this x1 of n will be now cos 2 pi 10, t should be replaced by nts. We know that ts is nothing but 1 by fs, so that's why this fs is there. Again, we know that fs is here given as 40 hertz, so let me replace that fs by 40. So if I write down this particular equation in its form, in its simpler form, my x1 of n comes to be cos 2 pi 1 by 4 n, or it is cos 5 by 2 n. That is how my x1 of n is represented, right? Now, secondly, again, let me represent this x2 of, let me sample this x2 of t also at sampling frequency nts. x2 of t, if it is sampled at t is equals to nts, I'm going to get x2 of n. This x2 of n is cos, okay, cos 2 pi 50, cos 2 pi 50, t is nothing but nts. This ts is nothing but again 1 by fs. This fs given is again 40, so here it is 40. So here it comes to be cos 2 pi 50 or 5/4n. Again, let me rearrange cos 2π 1 plus 1 by 4, we can write it as this one. Any ambiguity, any doubt with this? So, if you are coming across any ambiguity or doubt, you can very well comment or you can very well mail your doubts to me. We are there to solve your doubts. Either you can WhatsApp or you can call or you can write rightly comment here in that comment section. So, if I simplify this one, I'll be coming across cos 2π n plus 2π by 4 n, that is cos 2π n plus pi by this 2 by 4, it now comes to be pi by 2 n. So, again we know that cos 2π n plus theta is nothing but cos theta only. So, here it is cos pi by 2 n. This is 2. Now see here, what has happened is the signal which was having a frequency of 10 hertz and the signal. See here, concentrate on equation 1 and equation 2. x2 of n. Concentrate on these two equations and again revisit our equation here. x1 of t was having 10 hertz frequency and x2 of t was having 50 hertz frequency. But when I sample these two signals with a sampling frequency of 40 kilohertz, the sampled version of both the signals, they are giving me the same signal. That's what we have discussed earlier. F0th signal is now equivalently represented by F0 plus KFS. The signal with frequency F0 plus KFS. So, both of these signals are identical and we don't know which signal is a 10 hertz frequency signal and which signal is a 50 hertz frequency signal. Now, why this has happened? Because in both of these signals, the maximum frequency that was present here was 50. However, 50 hertz. Now, however, whenever we have sampled that particular signal, that signal was sampled with a frequency of 40 hertz. 40 hertz is not greater than, twice greater than 50 hertz. We have not followed the Nyquist criteria and hence we came across the concept of aliasing, wherein the higher frequency signal has taken the form of lower frequency signal. This is a 50 hertz signal analog in nature and this is a 10 hertz frequency signal which was analog in nature. Now both of these signals which were carrying these two frequencies, when they are there in digital domain, both of them were carrying the same form. That means same set of sample was representing a 10 hertz frequency signal and a 50 hertz frequency signal. Why this has happened again? This has happened because of disobeying that Nyquist criteria. Thank you.